I met Neil Diamond for the first time about 4 years ago. He was just about to play a series of 20 sold-out concerts in the Winter Garden Theater on Broadway. He was the first rock star ever to play a legitimate Broadway theater, and at the time, he was also one of the hottest acts in the music business. Then really, at the peak of his career, he just stopped performing. He said that he wanted to rest a while, to think about his music and about his life. And that was 4 years ago, but now Neil Diamond's come back. I met him again during the sound check before his opening concert at the Forest Hills Stadium in New York City. During a break, we talked about why he went away in the first place, why he came back, and what's ahead for one of the most talented men in music.
And the feeling is laid back. Palm trees grow and rents are low, but you know, keep thinking about making my way back. Well, I'm New York City born and raised, and nowadays I'm lost between two shoes. LA's fine, but it ain't home. New York's home, but it ain't mine no more.
In 72, the Winter Garden, I talked to you the afternoon before the first of 20 sold-out concerts, and at that time, you were certainly one of the top one, two, or three people in the whole industry. Why did you choose that time to go?
Well, I can't honestly say that I chose that particular time. Things were pretty hot at that time, but I pretty well decided a year before that I would really give my all to it for another year, and then I had to get away because the insanity was starting to creep in, and it was no longer a normal existence. And I wanted to get back to just a normal life. And of course, there's no better time to leave something than when you're on top. You know, you hope that you have the option of coming back whenever you want. And I felt pretty strong, and I felt that there were enough people out there who had seen the concerts and seen me in performance who would at least come back one more time to see what Neil Diamond was still doing. So I had hoped for that and felt that they might even wait a couple of years until I got my head together and got my act together. And it seems like they have, and so thank God it worked out okay.
Sure did.
Could have been disaster.
It wasn't, though. Did you get closer to your family, you know, to your kid?
Got closer to my family, was able to take my son to school in the morning. I mean, you know, those kind of things. It was very happy times for me. Tell him stories every night, put him to bed. I was able to come in and do some traveling. I was able to go out and see shows, see other performers, which you can't do while you're out there working. It gave me plenty of time to do what I wanted to do. Great deal of reading, a couple of years of therapy, you know, to work on those talking muscles and be able to express myself verbally. You know, I had done it before then, really basically through the music. It was one of the most worthwhile periods of my life. You know, I think taking a sabbatical, getting away from what you're doing for a little while, it doesn't have to be 3 or 4 years, it can be 3 or 4 months if you can do it,
right,
is a fantastic opportunity, and I wanted to take it.
So you're real happy now that you've done it. How does it feel to be back?
It feels great. I'm back because I want to be back. I'm excited about it. I'm not burned out. There are interesting places to play, whether it's Las Vegas or Australia or Forest Hills, and even going back to the Greek Theater in September. It's very exciting, and I'd like to do it as long as it is exciting.
You say you went through therapy. Was that an attempt kind of to find out what had happened to you over the 10 years? I mean, starting at a songwriter for $50 a week and then becoming the person who got probably the highest paid act in show business in Las Vegas in the Aladdin Annex.
Well, it was an attempt to find myself, and also I had an interesting experience. I went for a screen test for a film that they were doing at that time based on Lenny Bruce's life. I worked on it for a few weeks with Tom O'Horgan, and I went and did the screen test. And somehow, speaking Bruce's words thinking his thing and studying him the way that I did before that test, it opened up things in me that I didn't really know existed before, and I was a little afraid of them, you know. I began to think things, and I was angry. I was ready to, you know, because that's where Lenny Bruce was really at. And I started the therapy after that. I said, my God, there's got to be all kinds of places in my brain that I haven't begun to touch. And it was one way to do it. And I did it for 3.5 or 4 years. And I got my diploma. I thanked my analyst. He said, you need more time with me. I said, no, graduate after 4 years of college. I'm graduating now. It's been great, and, you know, I'll be seeing you.
A lot of people are very shy to talk about an experience as personal as that, but you're an upfront guy. You always were.
Well, it was a good experience for me. You know, the 4 years away, unbelievable. Because I'd been on the road, I'd been traveling, you know, hundreds of cities all over the world, and you never really get to see any of them when you're traveling. You know, it's in the airport, boom, the car to the hotel, boom, you get dressed, you go and you do your show. You're swept out of there before you can see anyone or anyone can see you, and you end up back in your hotel alone again. And I needed time. I need time for myself, for the person, you know, the celebrity and the performer, and that's great. But hidden underneath all of that is a human being, and I wanted to get to know him.
Tonight is going to be one of those hot August nights, I think.
Yes, it is. Yeah. Really hot.
Yeah. Thanks.
Okay,
thanks
brother.
For being with us.
Thanks. Okay. Good to see you again.
Good to see you again.
Yeah.
Man.
Okay.
Good luck. August night, Neil Diamond came back. I don't know if it's a hot August night where you are right now, but we'll be back with John Denver high in the Rocky Mountains. That's right after this.
And he lost a friend, but kept a memory.